Hey everybody, I has a box, and I has a bag, and I has another bag. Why am I talking funny? I don't know. It just felt right. It just felt right at that moment. In this box and in these bags, I definitely expect to find Lego stuff. So these should all be from Bricklink because it is that season for me to be getting stuff to, fill out my parts collection for things that I need to build, things that I am building, things that I want to build. To get into these, I has a knife. I'm going to be using this one. And of course, you know the deal on that. You can find my thoughts about it on the other channel. Let's get this first one open, start with this bag. Oh, nice. Nice slice, look at that. Oh, there's a piece of paper right there. It's gonna be the receipt. I'll remove that, but yeah, this is a good knife. Here, I get this piece of papier. Oot, good. Now I can spill this stuff out. Look at this. Oh, that is a good feeling right there. This is why I went to this particular store in the first place, to get these. I needed lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of these. I may end up needing lots more, but this is what I calculated that I needed, plus a large buffer. It depends on how I end up adjusting the design of the upper elevated platform for my first train station that I'm presently working on. That's what I needed out of this. And then I got some more of these because I just used up a bunch of them also on that train station. These can be used in the jungle area of my Minecraft region. These are cool too because these are just a regular green color, not the lime green color or anything like that. The store had some of these which I had run out of. I've got the trunks to go with these, so why not get some leaves. These are printed and these are great for radiator fan vents on the tops of the trains for the most part. Some white doors, solid orange. Thought I had enough of these. This is a great color. These were used for coconuts for Ninjago. That was cool. These are arches. Relatively new design. I wanted to have plenty of those available. These are cool, especially these in the trans black or dark brown or whatever color you want to call that. And got some light blue as well. These are doors in the trans black or brown. And this is miscellany. Really mixed up miscellany of various types of stuff. And there you can pretty much see what's there. So let's move on then to the next bag. Whoa, careful with that tripod there. Feels like there are, okay, this is safe now to get into. Feels like there's a base plate in here. Look at that cut. No effort. Oh, I love that. For a cheap knife, good to see. Let's see, get my own little preview. Uh-huh. That's what I thought. This is in there for the sake of stiffness, which is very good. And it's very much appreciated. Stiffness for these base plates, which are in old light gray. I think that's it for those. Piece of paper. More parts. Anything else in there parts-wise? I think so. I do believe. Yeah. Anything else parts-wise? Nope. That's it. Good. Let's see what we got. Forklift. Oh, this seller is a smoker. Oh. So I'm going to keep all these together and I'm going to dump all these into a bath to get all that smoke smell off of them. And I'm gonna throw these bags away outside. This is a Belleville bucket, big old thing. This is a nice old classic piece. And I also got a yellow fork piece that's compatible with this. It might be in this order. These are train doors. These are gray, dark bluish gray foliage pieces. This is the reason I came to this store to get these. I needed some more for my elevated platform for my train station. Again, never have enough parts to do what I want to do. Never. There's so much stuff in here. This is just all mixed up. I'm not going to spill this out because I want to keep this stuff together. There is that yellow fork. I can kind of move this around so you can see it. There's that yellow fork piece right there. Got a couple of these bars in black, which hold on to brushes, the street sweeper type brushes. And these, I think this color was actually used for the train wash. I may use it in my own custom train wash at some point. Some of these old doors. I think I have some parts that can hold these, and they're even in they're in modern gray, the color, with the proper spacing for those. That's great. Containers. This is a funky engine looking piece. It has a lot more angle, a lot more rake to it than I expected. I got a bunch of different colors of containers here because I had used up most of my special colors in my ice cream parlor. This is a nice keyboard piece. It's upside down right now. A couple of these black car. Sorry, I'm not going to take these out. I'm going to keep these all together because it really smells like smoke way too much. This is like car center seat, classic car pieces. There's just plain heads in light flesh color. Wow, some other heads. These are glow in the dark. Some freestyle style wheels. I've had some of those for a long time. Look at this. This is brown. Larger steering wheel piece in brown. So yeah, just miscellany. Lots of miscellany. It's just stuff that I kind of picked up on, mostly on impulse. Some of it I need, some of it I just want and know that I will use eventually. But this was the reason that I went to this particular store. I'm gonna keep these things separated out because that's the bad stuff with the smoke. Now, dun, 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 for the big one. This is jam-packed. This is absolutely full to the brim. It's heavy. There's more in here than it appears. Hundreds and hundreds of parts, including some that you've seen me get recently from a Bricklink haul. I've gotten some more. It says maybe a little bit of smoke smell, but nothing like those. I'm still smelling that. Brown, baby. Brown 2x4 bricks. Lots more of them. Look at how many hundred are in here. Let's see if the sheet, yeah, the sheet is in there. It's down at the base, but for my Minecraft snowy taiga, replenishment of the 2x2 bricks as well, which will be used in that area. There are more 2x2s. And then beyond that, everything just came down to other stuff that was matters of targets of opportunity. You know, I had used up a fair number of these. Didn't have any left. These I'm always using up, including in that Minecraft area. These I was definitely running low on, so I got way more than I should need for quite a while, but you never know. I've gotten lots of those in the past, not distant past. These should be useful for some Planetary Defense Force stuff, yeah. Mm-hmm. These are sand green, unprinted minifig heads. Now let me get a count for those bricks. Hopefully this actually is the right one. Yep, reddish brown 2x4 bricks. 300 of those. So 300 of these, and then 180 of these. What do you think about that? Think that'll be enough? I sure hope it'll be enough. I want to finish that. Did I really need to get these? I know they must have been cheap. They're new, not scuffed. They're quarter. Oh, duh. Yeah, I need these. I've just used up a ton of them. I'm about to use even more for my train station. So that's replenishment. It's not stuff that I presently need, but it's putting stock back in that I have taken out. And then a bunch of these rocks, because I always tend to look in the rock category of Bricklink stores when I look at them, and they had a bunch of these for cheap. I tend to use preformed stuff for quick and dirty terrain building. There we go. So that's what I got this time. Plenty of stuff. Some of it needs to be washed, obviously. The vast majority of the bulk of this obviously is going to be used in my Minecraft area. Some of it is going to be used on my train station, so both things that I'm working on presently. The rest of the stuff you will start to see little bits of from time to time. So yeah, that's it for now. I'm happy with this haul and I'm just anxious to go put these to use. Wash these, put everything else away, put these on the dryer, or put these out to dry, and start using these. Thanks for watching. I will talk to you again soon.